Hi there. In this tutorial, I'm going to cover the basics of how to construct the armature for this wing simulation. So I've got a very basic flapping motion here, but once you've got the armature set up, you can create any motion that you want. And the key point really is that each of the feathers appears to move relative to the one next to it, but less. So if you look at the feather at the bottom, you'll be able to see that that isn't moving as much as the main flight feather, the first one at the top. So let's get into that. So to begin with, we need to create our first bone, and this will be the bone from which all of the others come. I'll add an armature, which is a single bone to begin with. I'm going to change the look of the bones because they'll soon get in the way of each other. I'm going to create a more simplified wing for this tutorial. So if we go to Object Data Properties and Viewport Display, you can say how it's going to be displayed, and something like the stick is probably a good one to use so that it's fairly minimal. If we now go into edit mode, remembering this is the top of the bone, with my bone selected in edit mode, make sure that I've got the top selected. I'm going to press E, then Z, then 1. I'm just entering the data for the length of the bone so that I know exactly how long it is, and they can all be the same length, but it's not too critical. So if I move that now, you can see I've got a bone connected there. And while I'm here, if I go to the bone properties, this little bone symbol here, currently that's called bone 01. I'm going to call this primary bone just because it makes it easy to identify. Then I'm going to come back down here and select another one. Press E, and I'm just going to say X1 this time. So there's a second bone, and I'm going to say rotate Y minus 45. And you can see that one's being defaulted to bone 001, which is fine. And then I'm going to select here again and say EX1. So obviously I did more than that. I did about 10, but this is just to show you the basics of how it's done. Now I can go to pose mode and I'll select that first bone. If I press G, you can see it is connected. It won't go anywhere, but it will try to rotate and obviously doesn't affect the others. So what I'm going to do now is select this bone, the second one we created, and go to bone constraints, which is this option here. I'm going to add a bone constraint, which is a copy rotation constraint. I'm going to select in here and select my armature, and then click here and select my primary bone. The default name for this group of bones is armature, but you can call it anything you want. It's going to copy X, Y, and Z at the moment. And now let's see what happens if I rotate that bone. So I've opened my armature up here. If I go back and select my primary bone, I'll rotate it, but it seems like the bone 001 has disappeared because, of course, it's mapping 100% to my primary bone. So I go back to that bone 001 and come down to here and influence, and I'm going to change that to 0.5. I can even change it to less. You can see if it goes down to 0, it will revert back to where it was originally, and then rotating this bone does nothing. So if I put that back to 0.5, if you watch what happens with this bone, it's now rotating, but not as much as the first bone. Now I can select this one, again add a copy rotation constraint on there, select the armature, but this time select bone 001, and again I'll put 0.5 on that one. So that's given us three bones now, and what's obviously happening is this one is copying the rotation of this one, but only with a strength of 50%, and this one is copying the rotation of this one, also with a strength of 50%. And that's how you can go on. So I could go back to edit mode, add another bone, EX1, go back into pose mode, select this bone, add the copy rotation constraint, select the armature, this time selecting bone 2, because that's that one, and again setting it to 0.5. And again, we get this. If I go back to edit mode now, and I'm going to select all the bones now, Shift D to duplicate them, and then scale on the X minus 1, and then GX just to bring this wing over to here. And we've now got, if I go into pose mode, an identical set over here to here. It doesn't matter about this primary bones being slightly offset. The armature itself is not going to be visible anyway, and you can separate that and move it out if you want to. So believe it or not, that's all there is to the initial setup of the armature. But obviously what we have at the moment is a very simple armature that doesn't allow us in pose mode to, as it were, flap the wings. I can do it one wing at a time, but that's a bit on the painful side. So now I'm going to create a new armature somewhere about here. Notice I have just added a little bit of rotation in pose mode onto these wings, just to make sure that when I start to flap them, they just go in a predictable direction. rather than flicking around, which they can do. So I'm going to add an armature, which is a single bone. We'll just scale that down a little bit. Then we'll go into edit mode and I'll just duplicate that and duplicate it again. Not too worried about the criticality of the positioning, but I will center it up a bit. Again, the armature itself won't be visible, so I'm not too worried about it being absolutely perfect looking. So we've got three bones here and essentially they're part of the same armature. So I'm going to go to the bone properties, go into edit mode, and we'll call this one main control. We'll call this one right control, and we'll call this one, rather predictably, left control. There are our three bones. By making them separate bones rather than all just using a single bone, it gives us the option to have some independent movement between the wings. Now we're going to pose mode, which means I can move the bones around independently. And I'll select, in this case, the right control bone, and we'll go to constraints, and I'll just add a child of constraint. Before we go any further, I'll just rename this as the control armature, and then under target, we can select the control armature, and we can select the main control bone. So now in pose mode, that bone will move with that one. And then we'll do the same on the other side. So we'll add a child of, we'll select the control armature, we'll select the main control, and now we are set. So they're all linked together now. You could just use the central bone in the central armature, but as I said, this gives you the option to have independent movement and independent rotations and things like that. So it's essentially, it's like parenting. So I can move this around just as if it was a child of this one, but when I move this one, everything moves. We'll go back into object mode, select our main armature, and go back into pose mode. I'll select my right primary bone, and I'll add a bone constraint, which is a damped track constraint. I'll select the control armature, and the bone will be the right control bone. And now when I move this, we should see, if I go back into object mode, select this, go into pose mode, and you can now see that wing basically goes up and down with this. So I'll just do the same on the other side. I'll add a damped track, control armature, and the left control this time. And you can now see by moving this one up and down, I can get an effect on there. And I'm just going to move that out slightly. And you may need to adjust the number that you use for the constraints on here, because you can see I've got the feathers overlapping slightly there, which is probably not accurate. We've got a slightly off rotation on that one as well. I'm going to switch to my other armature in a moment. So you can see they'll move around like that as well. And it will move oddly, of course, if I do this. So what I want to do is parent this one to that one. So just Control P, just say object, and you can see I can move the main armature around now, and those control points will move with it, but won't change anything. But if I move the control points independently, they'll now affect the wings. So if I bring in the main armature that I created, you can see it's here, and it's basically the same concept. It's a little bit slow because I've also got a mesh attached to it. So just back here, I'll just show you briefly. It's fairly straightforward attaching a mesh to an armature, but there are a few little tricks to keep an eye on. So I'm just gonna scale this on the X. I'm not gonna worry about shaping this at all. I'm just gonna make a shape which would represent a feather. You can use alphas or you can model it however you want to, but you will need a little bit more geometry than comes as default. So I'm gonna add a few subdivisions there, and then just say subdivide, and that gives us a bit more. What I ended up doing was create this with an array because I wanted a lot of duplicates. But for this exercise, I'm just going to create several of them. But you can see initially we need to also change where the origin is. So go into edit mode, make sure everything is selected, and then just move it up so the origin is somewhere sensible. And then I can place this, I go into wireframe mode, over my first armature. I'm now going to go into edit mode. Created a duplicate. Unfortunately, in edit mode, of course, the origin doesn't work. I'm just going to position that roughly there, duplicate it again, and then one for the last one just here. And I would imagine they'll probably get smaller as you go. And again, I did that with an array. I just created an array, added an offset, which was an empty, rescaled the empty down slightly, and added a slight rotation. And then by using that as the offset, that automatically creates your feathers for you. I've demonstrated that in a number of tutorials. So here's my basic wings. Obviously, I need to create a duplicate of that. Scale X minus one, and we'll put that over there somewhere. It's roughly where it needs to be. I know that armature is not quite right. In fact, we need to move the whole thing back a little bit. And this isn't going to quite work because of the slight offsets I've got on that armature, but I just wanted to show really the basics. So I've got my basic wing feathers, select my armature, Control P and say armature, and I suggest with empty groups. You can try automatic weights, but you'll almost certainly find the armature is affecting more than the specific feather that should be affected. So I suggest with empty groups, and now you can select this, go here, and we can then scan up. So if we just talk about the primary bone, we know which part of the armature should be affected by that. As primary bone is the right hand primary bone, so I can select a vertex on there, Control L, and then assign that. And then you can see it's suddenly flicked down because it's gone where that one was sitting in pose mode. So then I can select this one, that'll presumably be bone 01, assign that. Select this one, that'll be bone 02, assign that. And then select this one, that'll be bone 03, assign that one. And then select my control armature and go into pose mode. You can see it's working. We probably need to adjust things a little bit. One thing you may need to do if you've made some adjustments like I have is just go to pose and say apply pose as rest pose. And then you can see they've all lined up again. It's just because it will keep changing pose when you go between pose mode and object mode. So if I now go back to object mode, you can see they're still all in the same place and that can confuse things. And now you can see they're sticking to the armature as you would expect. And that's really all there is to it. You can see I modeled some basic feather shapes here. I linked them all as I did with the other one that I showed you. And I've got a control bone here. If you start that a little higher up, it will give you a bit more control. But you can see this works in exactly the same way. And you may need to adjust, as I mentioned, how much of the influence is copied, how much of the rotation is copied under the influence. So 0.9, I had 10, seemed to be about the right level. You also may want to adjust the position of your feathers so they don't run into each other, as it were. So you, in this case, I've basically offset each feather, which is why you can see they're not completely lined up here. But you could also rotate them and that will cover most of it as well. And in terms of how I just briefly animated it, just to demonstrate it, all I did was I went to the graph editor, I selected my primary control bone. At the beginning of the animation, I pressed I in order just to add a single keyframe. And then under modifiers, I added a sign modifier to the Z location. And you can see there it is there. And then I did the same with the Y location as well. So that effectively, you can see, gives me a sort of sloped line with it going up and down. By having those at slightly different amplitudes, you can see it there, and slightly offset, so there's a slight phase offset, that gives me a sort of ellipse here for the movement, which is what drives the wings to sort of move forward slightly as they go down. So again, I just added the sign modifier. They've both got the same frequency. So if you look at Z and Y, that's got a phase multiplier of 0.25 and so has Z, but the phase offset is 0 for Y and minus 0.5 for Z. So that's what, as you can see, just offsets this blue, which is the Z curve, slightly. And then obviously play with the amplitude just to get the effect that you want. And that's what's given me this sort of flapping forward effect, but it's probably not completely realistic to the motion of a bird. It was just something that gave a bit of a look of something flapping. And then ultimately, obviously, you can hide your armature so that all you get to see is the motion of the wing. So I hope you found that useful. If you did, let me know. I will upload this source file for my Patreon subscribers to use. If you've got any questions on this or any other subject, please put that in the comments below. Otherwise, I will see you in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot. Thank you.